And we call it the year of Jericho. Why? Because some walls got to come down. Physical walls and spiritual walls. Like fear, intimidation, condemnation, inferiority, rejection, and my past. Anybody's got a past that needs to be forgiven, washed away, no longer control our lives, and move on. Amen? Yeah. Romania is the key to Europe. Romanians go throughout Europe looking for work. They establish churches there, and to those churches we are inviting. Of course, in front of Apovia, we have special lawn mowing services. This firm provides the lawn mowing and fertilization in one pass, and so we are grateful to our neighbor. And what are we doing? We do summer camps for youth, church families, and the children and orphans. We do conferences. We do conferences on what? Leadership skills, conflict resolution, and how to move and work in the Holy Spirit. Did you notice that this morning during the music time, the Holy Spirit was moving powerfully amongst us? It was beautiful, magnificent. It wasn't force. It wasn't hype. Was supported. Amen. And then future planning. So this is just a little vignette of some of the camps we did this past year. This is our mayor. Where did you go, mayor? There he is. That is our mayor. He and his wife attend almost every conference we do, and his wife helps prepare the food. How's that for a good? Okay, and here's a group of 50 young people I was asked that they were leaving to pray for them. As a twig is bent, so grows the tree. And what an honor to have a little influence in these lives. And here we had 50 plus for a week. And here's some conferences that we've done. You notice we have a parking issue and so on. We did a singles and couples growing confidence. And anybody know those two? That man was my pastor 40 years ago. And that's Clay and Marlene Glicker. And they were there and did a marriage conference. They were on radio. They did a conference in the 1,100 member church on marriage and so on. We built this conference hall for 35 to 40 people. Over 70 people have been coming. So you see, we've got people on the stairs there. And the overhead here, this is a support for balcony overhead, and people were filling the balcony because they're hungry. They're coming, over 70, magnificent. I put my picture up there so you can see that, you know, I'm there too. Of course, I've taken most of these pictures here, and this man, within their culture, he is known as an apostle. And indeed, he's a magnificent young man of God. The beautiful things that God did. And here we have a Korean missionary with his wife, whose name is Svetlana, and our brother, DeMonte Edmonds. This is our mode of transportation. That's my sister driving that mode of transportation. 9-passenger Volkswagen van. God sent us this past year these 6 young ladies, plus one. And we had them for 3 weeks. What an opportunity. What a golden opportunity. We took them with us wherever we went to give them missionary living experience. And then after that, they liked it so much they sent us another group of 3 guys and 4 gals for 3 weeks. Be able to speak into their lives in some way. This house across the street from us, for sale for some years ago. We prayed and we negotiated with the owner, and he said he wanted 50,000 euros. I said, I can build new for that. He said, well, that's the price. Well, older brother of the negotiating team went to heaven, we hope. And his wife and the younger brother were very, very other-minded. And they asked us if we wanted to buy it. So we sat down to negotiate, and the wife of the deceased said, what do you offer? I said, 13,000 euros. She rose up, came, shook my hand, and she said, you got a deal. So God is good. I love win-win situations.
Yes, yes.
They were happy, and we were happy. And so this is now becoming our new conference hall.
Wow.
So watch what we've been doing. There's the closing on the property. There's the younger brother, and there's the widow, and there's the widow's son. And so this is the property that we're developing. This has happened this past year. And so the walls are gonna come down to make room. And so we hired some American to come down and help with, oh, that's me. Okay. And so the walls are coming down, and yes, we work hard. The young people that came, they helped, and we got a team from the United States. They came. This is my Pastor Wooden. Pastor Tony knows him, Pastor Dill. And it's interesting that those guys had construction skills. Sometimes pastors can do more than just preach and teach, you know. And so this is the team that God sent us. My sister, Schnookums, your humble servant, and they did a magnificent job in ministry, reaching out to the local population. This is a very important place we need to build very quickly. And this is our five-star outhouse. We have electric light inside, and there you go. And the mayor gave us this loader excavator for a day with a driver, and so we are building a septic system in there so we can have Western-style plumbing. And there's our ladies working hard, pastors, both of them, with their construction skills, repairing the ceiling, pouring new floors, putting in the new windows. This is what happens with your missionary dollars. Not for the building, but for a place to bring people so that they can be trained and helped and lifted, and the walls come down. And so this is somewhat the way it looks when we left. It's got more work to do. I would say it's 60% completed. There's my sister. After everybody else left at the end of the day, my sister went in there and cleaned up after the workers. And I'm that. So why are we there? Well, for these young people. And they come. Why are we there? For these magnificent children. Look at those beautiful children. You know, and we have opportunity to speak into their lives. This is my not my bucket list, my want list. And with much breath to say amen, and that's the end of part one. And I just use 8 minutes. Okay, got a little bit more to go. Watch this. Sometimes we need to forget about what we like to do and get the job done. Okay, now this is for you folks. You know, it's one thing to look at what we're doing, but we're all called. We all have a job. Every person that is born has significance. If you're still on earth, you're here for a purpose. You will meet with obstacles. Don't think you might escape them. You will. But will perseverance, pressing on and pressing through, that's how the kingdom is built. And then we celebrate accomplishments. And so I have 7 examples from the Old Testament, about 1 minute for each example. And then that's you. The Bible says whatever was written in the Old Testament was written for our learning, that we New Testament people might have hope. And they got the job done. They did it anyway. Would you say that they did it anyway, please?
They did it anyway.
Can you do it a little bit more humph?
They did it anyway.
Okay, because I'm going to call on you to help me, okay? Build the ark, Noah. If Noah didn't build the ark, who would he be? You hear a little bit of us perhaps preaching, but if he didn't build the ark, he didn't get the job done. He had a lot of excuses. Oh, it's too big. I don't have any experience. I'm too old to begin. And people will laugh at me. But what did he do?
He did it anyway.
Thank you very much. Okay. Abraham, get out where you live and go to the promised land. Oh, but all the excuses. It's too far. It's scary. It's family. What would he do?
He did it anyway.
Okay. What are you going to do?
Do it anyway.
Okay. Here we go. Joseph. There's coming a famine. I need somebody to prepare a place for God's people. But what are you going to do, Joseph? Use your excuses. I'm too young. I got family problems. Everything's gotten wrong. And I'm a jailbird. I've been in jail. Anybody here been in jail? I have. I ministered there. Yes. Okay. They've been in jail. But what did he do?
Did it anyway.
Okay. Lead God's children out of Egypt now into the promised land, okay? But I'm a wanted man. That's what Moses could have said. Nobody would believe me. I can't talk. I remember he was a stutterer. And there's a sea in the way. There's all kinds of problems. If God has called you to do something, you're going to confront problems. You're going to confront issues. If it's not a sea, if it's not a giant, it'll be something. And the question is, what are you going to do? And he
did anyway.
Okay. Joshua, now it's time to go into the promised land. But there are problems. There's the river. There's the walls. There's no army. And there's these strange methods. Maybe we would call them spiritual weapons to bring down walls. And so he had all these issues confronting him. And you know what he did? What did he do?
He did it.
Okay, what are you going to do?
Okay.
And of course, David, teach my people to worship. Well, you could have said, well, I'm just. Never say about yourself, you're just anything. I'm just a woman. I'm just this. I'm just that. Forget the just. He could have said, I'm just a shepherd. I'm all alone, never studied music, and the king don't like me. The government don't like me. The supreme, you gotta. Thank you very much. I know you come through for me. Okay, Nehemiah, come on now. Nehemiah, build that wall. Oh, but Lord, I don't have this. I don't have that. I have this problem. I have that problem. Lord, what should I do?
Do it anyway.
What are we going to do?
Do it anyway.
Okay. And he did it anyway. And see, you got a dream, dear saint. You're on earth. You're not here just to make money and live in rat racing to pay the rent so you can go back to the job and make more money so you can. No, that's the rat race. You're here for significance. You're here for a purpose. You're here for the kingdom of God. Within and without. And so you got a dream, a job to do. Folks, you got to get the job done. You know, this year, I cut down a lot of my preaching. Why? I knew my job was to get this conference room ready. Whether I preach or whether I can get 120 men and women together and have men like Pastor Tony come and teach them about the kingdom of God. Which is more valuable? I preach a sermon or get 120 leaders and pastors together and turn our ministers loose on them. I knew I had to get the job done. So I love to preach. You can tell I love to preach because I'm a good preacher. Should I repeat that? But no, I knew that I had to get the job done. So don't allow people, negative, rain on your parade, people. No, don't let them stop you. Okay. Jesus. He rejected him and he didn't have to do it. His love made him do it. He did it anyway. And you have gifts, you have talents. It may not be preaching, it may not be on television, but wherever you are, wherever God has called you to be, you know, there's a job for you to do. You're not here for nothing. You're here for a purpose. You have destiny. And so Discover what God has put within you. Develop what God has put within you. And then deploy it. Because this generation needs what God put inside of you. And so, Noah, he did it. Help me now. Noah.
Did it anyway.
Abram.
Did it anyway.
Joseph.
Did it anyway.
Moses.
Did it anyway.
Joshua.
Did it anyway.
Nehemiah.
David.
Jesus. Okay. They did it anyway. And what are we going to do?
Do it anyway.
Amen. And so, what will make you do it? Do it anyway. Do God's will for your life. Many are doing it. I'm trying to do it. And let's join together and get the job done. And one, two, three.
Do it anyway.
Amen. Thank you.
Amen.